Jesus concluded his message. He told his listeners that if they were to enter into his kingdom, they must enter through the narrow gate. See, the other gate is wide and broad, and that gate leads to destruction. And many, many are those who enter by that wide and broad gate. Jesus said, enter through the narrow gate, for that gate is small, and the way may be narrow, but that gate leads to life. And few will enter that narrow gate, let alone find it. In order for us to find the narrow gate, sometimes we need a sign. And I don't mean a miracle, I mean an actual physical sign. Throughout this road trip we call life, God has given us practical life maps, which is his word. But we also need to pay attention to the road signs along the way. Jesus made it very clear that there are only two gates, only two paths, two destinations before every man and woman. And each of us must choose one or the other. And to some, this may sound surprising. Many believe that we are confronted with almost infinite number of alternatives. That is not a choice between only two options, but a choice between many. But if that was the case, that we had all these alternatives, how can one person choose the right one? Now, because of this dilemma, many have concluded that all roads lead to heaven, and that it matters little to which one would choose. However, Jesus narrows our choices to only two. We must follow the road signs to the one narrow path. God has given us a practical life map to live our lives for him. He has pointed to our final destination. The Bible tells us which roads we should travel and which roads we should avoid. It explains everything we need to know for this earthly life on our way to heaven. But sometimes life is like our man-made road map that we unfold and then can't fold back together. Have you ever tried doing that? Good thing we have GPS on our phones and in our cars. But sometimes we don't know the best destination to take. Another way of saying this, sometimes we need to ask ourselves, what now? What do I do when we don't know what to do? Where do I turn when I don't know what direction to go? Other times, though, it's very clear which way to go. There was only one way to go when Chris Parker, a 33-year-old homeless man, saw the panic and chaos coming out of the Manchester Arena this past week. See, Chris and another homeless man that he was sitting with outside the entrance saw the chaos coming out of the concert. Rather than running the other way, there was only one way for the two men to go. Both men headed toward the chaos, though many fled in confusion. Both went to the aid of victims, one comforting a girl who had lost both of her legs, and the other cradling a dying woman in his arms. Now, who knows what path and roadways both of these men took to bring them to the places they were in life? Maybe they didn't avoid the roads that they should have. Maybe they got off on the wrong exit. But that night in Manchester, there was only one way for them to go. And though what happened in Manchester was a tragedy, and is a tragedy, the actions of Mr. Parker may have helped heal a family rift. After hearing on the news about what her son had done, Chris Parker's mother reached out to the news. And she's quoted by saying, "This is my son, and I'm desperate to get in touch with him. We have been estranged for many years, and I have no idea he was homeless. I'm very proud of him, and I think he might need me right now. Amidst this tragedy, humanity rose above and old connections were renewed. Possibly, people had gotten on the right path again. God will show us which way to go. Every day, God shows us signs to direct our path, but we have to pay attention. This morning and over the next few weeks, we're going to discover together road signs for life. Specific road signs that, if you follow them, will guide you in the right direction. Always. This is 100% guaranteed. If you follow God's direction, you will be assured of being on the right path. Now, how do I know this is 100% guaranteed? It's because it's God's word and God guarantees it. Proverbs 2:9 says, you will understand what is right, just, and fair, and you will know how to find the right course of action every time. If you want to make sure you are always going in the right direction, if you want to make sure your decisions are always the best, then God has provided road signs for our lives. And the first sign we're going to look at is one way. There's only one way. The small gate is the entrance to the narrow way, the way which leads to eternal life. That gate is our Lord Jesus himself.
Amen.
In the words of the Savior, truly, truly, I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. I am the door. If anyone enters through me, he shall be saved, and go in and out and find pasture. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. That's John 10, verses 7, 9, and 11. In John 14, verse 6, we read this morning, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. God's only provision for man's salvation is an entrance to the kingdom is through Jesus and faith in Jesus Christ as our Savior. However, then, why is the gate so small and narrow? Simply put, it's because it's restrictive and exclusive, but in a different way than we might think. It's not because that gate is poorly marked. Jesus publicly pointed out that he was God's provision for the forgiveness of sins and entrance to eternal life. And in and of that is why that gate is restrictive and exclusive. We must go through Jesus Christ. There's only one way, only one gate to eternal life. And it's a gate that few will enter. Some may think, how can this be? It's because we are saved by a personal act of faith. It's a personal and individual decision to follow the path to the narrow gate. 1 Timothy 2, verses 5 and 6, and Hebrews 9, 11 say that man can only approach God through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. We are never saved in clusters, but individually. Think of it this way. Has anyone ever gone through one of those rotating doors? Have you ever tried to go through one? I like them. I just go round and round and round. Have you ever tried to go into that circular door with more than, just trying to fill it with people? What's going to happen? It's going to get stuck. Likewise, a wide door, when they have the Black Friday sales, people just, they open the doors and it floods open with people. And what happens? People get trampled on. People get hurt. It's better to go through one at a time, through the narrow open instead of the wide open that leads to destruction. While God's way of salvation is exclusive and restrictive, the gate to hell is broad and inviting. You can go to hell as an atheist or agnostic. You can go there under any denominational label that you choose. If you want to enter God's kingdom, do not follow the crowds, but trust in the Son of God who died for your sins and who offers to give you his righteousness. Do not attempt to add to or take away his means of salvation. The means of salvation is Jesus Christ. Though it is narrow, there is only one way. Scripture tells us in Psalm 3, verse 8, salvation is of the Lord. Now, this is what really may irritate people to a certain extent, or those questioning their faith. They may say, why is there only one way? Or, I believe that if you're a good person, you'll go to heaven. The answer is God has declared in his word that there is no other way of salvation than through faith in his Son. So again, don't attempt to add to or take away the means of salvation to that narrow gate. We would gladly choose any other way than God's way if we could, wouldn't we, as human beings? Because all other ways would allow us to keep our pride, our possessions, and our preferences. But God will have none of that. There's only one way. Your eternal destiny hangs upon your choice between two alternatives. You may go the tolerant and accommodating way, which is well-traveled, and on one which there you will have a great deal of company, the wide gate. However, you will find that this way is destructive. But on the other hand, you may follow the right road signs and take the narrow and restrictive way, faith in Jesus Christ. And again, this leads to life. You will never walk alone, but neither will you be with the majority. Your path may be narrow, but your destiny is sure. Jesus Christ confronts every man with this choice. The decision that every man must make is not an easy one. For there are many godless guides that would lead us to a wide gate that is welcoming, but leads to destruction. The wise man is he who hears the teaching of Jesus and applies his teaching to the matter of his personal salvation. We must take the step of entrusting our eternal destiny to Jesus based on his word and his work. Beyond this, we must continue to attempt to apply his teaching to our everyday lives. Remember the story of the man who built his house on the rock and the man who built his house on the sand? The reason why one house fell and the other stood is that one had a sure foundation, while the other did not. The solid foundation is the teaching of the Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and acts upon them may be compared to a wise man. Both men built the house. The only difference in the houses is the foundations. One was built upon the rock and the other sand. The one house was built upon the Lord's teaching, while the other was built apart from it. The sad fact of life is that men and women are building their entire lives by staking their eternal destiny, not upon the Word of God, not by following the road signs, but on their own preconceived notions and preferences. Whether we enter either by the narrow gate or the wide one. The end of each pathway is still well out of sight. The foundation upon which one builds his life is not tested until the great storm comes. We will not learn the folly of choosing the wrong gate, the wrong foundation, the wrong road signs for life until it's too late to reverse our destiny. May I ask you, what gate have you chosen? You must choose one, and your choices are limited to only two. The narrow gate of salvation through faith in Christ, or the wide gate which is wide open and open to all, but leads to destruction. As I close this message today, I want you to think for a moment. How many decisions did you make this week based on only one way? How many decisions did you make when you actually stopped and asked, is this the best decision for me? Is it the best decision for my family? For my testimony to others? Am I going the wrong way? Sometimes we choose the good and lose out on the best. This road sign does not ask what is good to do. There are lots of good things to do to fill our time. This sign helps point us in the direction that is best for us. Because Jesus is the way and the truth and the life. He's the only way and the one way to heaven. This morning, may you choose the one way to salvation.